she was three, but her mother still could feel him. Signor Magnifico had a spring in his feet, he had a fall in his sleep, and a longing in his weeping. Before a fight, the good signor would wash his hands and close the door. He prayed a god to make him strong, and the other man we got worried, and so he'd rip into the ring, and as he screamed the crowds would sing, please with his victory will he bring our lives some living. He sees opponent always big as a bear, with long dark hair and a face for the wearing. So good signor would take the spring from his feet, the fall from his sleep, and his longing for the would watch him lay low all their feared foes. So low they'd go in the arms of Mifico. Signor grew older, their glorious holder of proving stronger, of living longer. And then one day the undefeated signor met another undefeated competitor. Roar, roar, roar.
This is the part of the song where Signor Magnifico meets death in the ring. Death's mask was white and black and blue and yellow and red, and he sat silently in the corner of the ring. All the country was there, waiting, watching from afar and from near for Signor to oppose their foes. And as he ripped into the ring, they rose for their hero. And the match began.
Get up, Magnifico, get up, Magnifico, they cried, get up, Magnifico, get up, Magnifico, get up, Magnifico, get up, Magnifico.
relief, they cried, "Get up, Magnifico." And as he laid low all of Mexico, they watched him bow to life's most valiant foe. Laid low and so the great senor did go. As he lay, he drifted off to the sea, to his daughter now of 33, and the woman who once could feel him. The bus was bumpy, his stomach jumpy, he thought of the ring and of the crowds. Would his name remain? Where he belonged would have to change. But when he got there, he stood one time more outside their little front door, and feared that time had been